Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Not too long from now, we can hopefully expect to see a Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 10-2 mission is currently scheduled for tomorrow, Thursday 13th at 1 a.m. UTC, or today, Wednesday 12th at 9 p.m. EST. No more launches for the rest of the week, but next week we can hopefully expect a customer launch. The Astra 1P SES-24 mission is currently scheduled for Monday 17th at 9:35 p.m. UTC or 5:35 p.m. EST. Then, a couple of days later, and we should see another Starlink launch. The Starlink 9-1 mission is currently scheduled for Wednesday 19th at 3 a.m. UTC or Tuesday 18th at 11 p.m. EST. NASA posted an EIS document about launching Starship from LC-39A in Florida, and Zach Golden posted some notable points from the document. He said, Starship Environmental Impact Statement for LC-39A. Some notable mentions from this document include vehicle design, 35 engines on Super Heavy and 9 engines on Starship. Expected launch cadence up to 44 launches per year from Starship at 39A with landings permitted both at the pad and on drone ships. Pad infrastructure, a separate catch tower which is located further to the south from the existing integration tower. Heading to Boca Chica, work to get the orbital launch pad ready for Flight 5 has commenced. Concrete was seen being poured for orbital pad B. These feet for the pad B tower were delivered to the launch site. The work on the new office building has been continuing. Everyday astronaut posted wondering how the orbital launch pad held up after Flight 4. Musk responded and said no major damage. Marcus House posted wondering about damage to Ship 29 and Musk responded with some information. Marcus said, I'd love to know if there were any similar symptoms on any of the other three flaps. Given SpaceX are now completely replacing the heat shield on the Flight 5 Starship, would love to know how the other flaps held. Musk responded with, left flap also got very hot but was less damaged. Rear flap seemed to be okay based on their control authority but probably lost some tiles. Elon Musk did a gaming stream recently and talked a bit about Starship Flight 5 and major changes to the heat shield. Starship Gazer posted saying Elon says Starship Flight 5 in about a month. And they'll be making huge changes to the heat shield for the next ship, which should be Starship 30. The B14.1 test tank has been spotted with a cap to test the force of a booster catch. Starship Gazer posted a picture of work on Ship 30's heat shield and said the removal of all of Starship 30's heat shield tiles has begun. This Booster 15 LOX barrel section was spotted staged outside Mega Bay 1. As always, I have to say thanks to both Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Gal, and Sean Doherty for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.